start the next topic, that is compensators. So in this compensators, we can see there are two types of compensator. Basically, the effect of compensation, it depends upon the position of compensation circuit where it is placed. So we can say that the compensation circuit, its position, basically where it is placed, that determines its effect. So what kind of effect it will have will depend upon its position in the circuit. So first of all, we can see there are two common topologies for it. First is your cascade combination, in which it is placed in series with the forward control network. So in the first cascade compensation, it is placed in series with your forward control network, and second compensation type will be your feedback compensation, and it is placed in series with the feedback network. So in your feedback network, this here is basically feedback compensation, that is the second type of compensation. Here R is your input, this is your summer, here G is your gain element, then H is your feedback element, and K here indicates your compensation circuit. So K indicates the compensation circuit. Now when compensation circuit is placed in series with the feedback network, so when this feedback network is there in series with your compensation circuit, then it forms feedback compensation. And when your compensation circuit at K is in series with your gain element, that is forward control network, this is forward control network, and in series with it, when we have our compensation circuit K, then it will result in your cascade compensation. So the two most common topologies of compensation are cascade compensation and feedback compensation. So for cascade compensation, our compensation circuitry will be in series with the forward gain network, and for feedback compensation, our compensation circuitry will be in series with the feedback network. Next, we are going to see the different types of compensators. So there are basically three types of compensators: lead compensators, lag compensators, and the third one is basically combination of the two, that is the lead and lag compensators. That makes it lead lag compensators. So first of all, we are going to start with our first type, the very first type, that is lead compensators. In this, the transfer function for lead compensator will be of this format: S plus A by S plus B. This will be your format of transfer function of lead compensator. So from this we can see the numerator represents your 0. So it has a 0 at S equals to minus A and a pole at S equals to minus B. So this denominator indicates pole, numerator indicates 0. So S plus A will give you S equals to minus A, that is your 0, and S equals to minus B, that is your pole. For lead compensation, what happens? We can see that B will always be greater than A. The condition for lead compensator is B greater than A, and the phase shift will be positive. So what is that? The name indicates that lead compensator, in that case, the phase shift will always be positive. The phase shift will be positive. So here we can write that the transfer function, basically, you can indicate it by G, or let's say we indicate it by T of S equals to S plus A over S plus B. Now T of J omega makes it J omega plus A over J omega plus B. Now for phase, for determining phase, that is phi will be your argument of this J omega plus A over J omega plus B. Can be written, the argument calculation will be argument of J omega plus A minus argument of J omega plus B, because argument of C by D in general is written as argument of C minus argument of D. So this is the property of argument which we can use here, and argument of this particular one, that is tan inverse omega by A minus tan inverse omega by B, B for this second part. Now what we can see, the next thing is for B greater than A, one thing we need to note is for B greater than A, greater than A, and we can say 1 by B will be less than 1 by A, multiplying omega both sides, omega by B is less than omega by A. So what we obtain, that omega by A will be your bigger number and omega by B will be your smaller number. So definitely omega by A is bigger number and this is your smaller number. So tan inverse of smaller value will be also small, and that tan inverse of bigger value will be bigger. So bigger minus smaller will give you some positive value. So your phase, that is change in phase, fine, this comes out to be positive. So we can say it is positive, delta of phi is positive because tan inverse is monotonically increasing function. Since it is monotonically increasing function, so here from this calculation that the condition for lead compensation was A greater than A less than B or B greater than A, we can see, and from reciprocating it, it becomes just the opposite sign comes, because if B is greater than A, then taking reciprocal makes 1 by A greater than 1 by B, and multiplying omega both sides will not change the sign. That means omega by A is greater than omega by B. So that way our phase will come as positive for this, and tan inverse is monotonically increasing function. So further what we are going to see, that how can we make circuit for this. So circuit for lead compensator can be made by putting RC shunt, that is a parallel RC circuitry, as Z1 and resistance as Z2. In which circuit? In figure 7 we need to refer for it. That is this. This is a diagram for phase modification. Here this is our input, this is our Z1, this is our Z2, and this is our output. So here in place of Z1 we are going to place RC shunt, and in place of Z2 we are going to place a resistance. Then we are going to obtain the transfer function V out over V in. So for finding V out over V in, what we need to check is we can apply voltage divider and we can obtain that expression. So seeing this way, so here we can see that for lead compensator, first of all we need to put RC shunt as Z1 and resistance as Z2. So the resistance can be taken as here R2, and Z1 can be taken as RC parallel circuitry. So that will be basically resistance R1 in parallel with capacitance C1. So this is complete your Z1, and in the Z2 case we are going to take its value as R2 here. Here was our input, V input applied, and at this point we are going to take V output. So basically this is your Z2 component, and this complete is your Z1 component. So Z1 is basically parallel of these, so it comes out to be R1 multiplied by 1 by SC of this, R1 plus 1 by SC. So when we take parallel combination of a resistance and a capacitor, then this will be our output resistance, equivalent resistance for this Z1. So this can be seen over here, and this when simplified will result here, and Z2 equals to R2 because it is single resistance. Now the response for it will be V0 by VI equals to this Z1 upon Z1 plus Z2. Placing the values and substituting it, we get this expression. Here we can assume that this 1 by R1C is equals to A, and this particular portion S plus this complete will be equals to B, so that we can say S plus A over S plus B will be your V0 by VI. That is the transfer function for lead compensator. So here these are some assumptions. equals to A, this particular equals to B, and we can see that B is greater than A. So for phase lead compensator, it is a form of high pass filter. So phase lead compensator is a form of high pass filter, and the compensator introduces gain at high frequencies. What the compensator introduces is, it introduces a gain at high frequency, which increases in stability and phase lead, which tends to be stabilizing. So these compensators, they introduce phase high frequency, and they increases the instability and phase lead, and they tend to be stabilizing. So the pole and zero are typically placed in high frequency region. So this way we can see our first type of compensator is done over here, and next is our second type, that is a lag compensator. So for lag compensator, we can say that the transfer function for this will be S plus B over S plus A, which has a 0 at S equals to minus B and a pole at S equals to minus A. For lag compensation, we note the condition that B is greater than A. So that is going to make your phase shift is always negative. So we remember that for lead compensator, our phase shift was positive, and for lag compensator, our phase shift will be negative. So just placing S equals to j omega here and taking argument of it, we are going to obtain this phase phi. So further, we can write tan inverse omega by b minus tan inverse omega by a. As we know, for b greater than a condition, our omega by a will be greater than omega by b, as we saw before. So for that, we can say this value is bigger, this value is smaller. So smaller minus bigger value will give you a resulting negative value. So our phase delta phi will result in negative value. So this is negative because tan inverse is monotonically increasing function. So what is your tan inverse? It is monotonically increasing function, and we can make a circuit of figure 7. The figure 7 was like this. Z1 here component. Here was your Z2 component. This was your output, V output, from this portion. And from these two terminals, here we apply your input. And from here, you are going to take your output. So basically for this, what you can see is, for a lag compensator, here you are going to put resistance as Z1. So your resistance value will be Z1 and a resistance, and capacitance in series as Z2. So what will be your Z2 is, Z2 will be a series combination of R and C. So it will look like R2 in series with C. So this will be it, and its equivalent impedance, or you can say equivalent resistance, can be written as R2 plus 1 by SC. So this will be your Z2, and Z1 is equivalent to, or R1 value, because it is a single resistance. So here you can see that Z1 equals to R1, Z2 equals to R2 1 by SC, same is written. When you are going to obtain V out by V in, for writing V out by V in, it will be basically Z2 over Z1 plus Z2. So Z2 over Z1 plus Z2, that will be, and so here Z2 can be placed as this, and Z1 plus Z2 can be placed by this complete value. And then further, this can be assumed as A and B. So we can here do some rearranging of terms. That is, this particular is equals to V naught upon V in, and this is going to be a transfer function for V naught by V in. Now arranging some terms and making it as S plus some component in numerator, S plus some terms in denominator will make it this form. And so here you are going to suppose 1 by R2C equals to B, and 1 by R1 plus R2C equals to A. So this way you can see these are the assumptions we made. And for A, for B greater than A, you can see that your lag compensator. This is a simple form of low pass filter. Your lead compensator was a form of high pass filter, and lag compensator, that is the phase lag compensator, is a form of low pass filter. It reduces the gain at high frequency. So it reduces your gain at high frequencies. It also tends to stabilize the system, and it introduces a phase lag because the phase increases, as the name of it indicates. Lag compensator, though, the phase will be definitely lagging, and it tends to destabilize your system. So with the help of it, your system will be destabilized. Means it will try to disturb your stability of the system. The pole and zero of the compensator are usually placed in the low frequency region. So here your pole and zero of the compensator are going to be placed in your low frequency region. You can also see to the third part of the lead lag compensator. So the third part of lead lag compensator, basically the transfer function for a lead lag compensator will be of this form: S plus A1 into S plus B2 over S plus B1 into S plus A2. Here B1 will be greater than A1 and B2 will be greater than A2. So with RC as parallel circuit, we are going to take as Z1, and RC series circuit, RC series circuit, we are going to take as Z2. So RC series circuit means when R and C are in series combination, then you can say R2 and C2. So it will be R2 plus 1 by C2, SC2 as your equivalent impedance for it. So R2 1 by SC2, and your parallel circuit, that is Z1, basically equivalent to R in parallel with your capacitance 1 by, you can write this C as 1 by SC1, so as to avoid the complexity of C capacitance, because it is taken for both Z1 and Z2. We will write one as C1 and another as C2. So this equivalent impedance Z1 will be resulting in Z1 equals to R1 into 1 by SC1 over R1 plus 1 by SC1. So this can be rearranged and written into this format: R1 over 1 plus SC1. Now Z2 over Z1 plus Z2 will result into this format: R2 plus 1 by SC2 over this. So rearranging this completely, we are going to have two product terms in numerator and this complete expression in your denominator. So now we can say that this means our requirements for lead lag compensator with this term can be assumed as A1, this as B2, this as A1, this as B2, because our expression is S plus A1, S plus B2, and then in the denominator also we need to assume and we need to make them pair. So you can do this way, and after rearranging and taking all the assumptions, what you are going to say that there are some advantages as well as disadvantages of the various types of compensation, that is differences we can see over here. So we can just revise the summary as a bit. So there are two types of compensation, namely phase lead, phase lag and phase lead compensation. Advantage of phase lag are low frequency characteristic is improved, stability margins maintained, or you can say improved, bandwidth is reduced, and it is useful in high frequency noise in a problem. So it is useful if there is a high frequency noise in a problem, it can be used. That means bandwidth can be reduced, stability margins can be improved or they can be maintained, and low frequency characteristics can also be improved. So what are the disadvantages for this is at least one slow term in transient response. So by the use of this phase lag compensator, we are going to have at least one slow term in our transient response. Next is our phase lead compensator. This improved stability margin, improved high frequency response, and this may be required for stability. Its disadvantage There is one more disadvantage for phase lag, that is reduced bandwidth may be its disadvantage. So for phase lead, the disadvantage will be possible high frequency noise problems, and this may generate large signals out of linear range of system. So the phase lead compensator, this basically results in high frequency noise problems, and it may generate large signals and also out of linear range of system. So this is all about your compensator circuitry. So that's all.